Good morning. Welcome to John's Morning Focus. Today we're going to talk about how to get out of a sales slump with your team. And very simply, you're a sales manager or a supervisor and your team is underperforming. How to get out of it? Well, first thing to do is determine where is the opportunity to improve. For example, as the manager or supervisor, first I would look and see if it's something that has to do with you. For example, make sure that you're very clear on the goals that your company is providing you. Once you're clear on that, then next see, is there an opportunity to better communicate to your team what you're all trying to achieve? And we can always improve our communication skills, our leadership skills, our sales skills. And I would recommend in that case, definitely talk to your own supervisor. But certainly supervisors always like when someone takes it upon themselves to improve so that they can ultimately achieve the goals that have been given to them. For example, I love podcasts and books, and I highly suggest looking into books by John Maxwell, Darren Hardy, and Brian Tracy in terms of determining how to better communicate what it is you're trying to get out there. So now let's say that you're all okay, you're communicating well, you're clear on your goals. The issue probably doesn't lie with you, but rather some of your direct reports are struggling, okay? It's important to determine if the opportunities to improve lie in the area of skill or will. What do I mean by that? Skill very simply means that there's an ability currently lacking that the person that you're working with, a part of your team, is not putting into action. And that is trainable. There's information that they don't know, and it's simply an opportunity of getting it to them and bringing it to them. And also, then I highly recommend looking into different issues such as, are you regularly speaking about the whole sales process, the product, the features, the benefits, and the probing questions? And on a private level, again, everybody loves when the people that work for them take it upon themselves to learn. I highly recommend listening to inspirational information and sales skills by the same people I mentioned before, Darren Hardy, Brian Tracy, and John Maxwell, as well as Zig Ziglar, Les Brown, Tony Robbins, Tom Hopkins, Grant Cardone, numerous people. And perhaps you could suggest having podcasts listened to in the car or bring them into your own team meetings. Now, years ago, I worked in insurance, my first professional sales job. I've been in sales for 25 years, and as a life coach and continuing in sales, we're always all involved in negotiation, persuasion skills. Zig Ziglar tells us that you can have anything you want if you help enough other people get what they want. So really, in essence, if it's just trying to convince someone where to go for lunch that day, we are involved in sales, right? And trying to make a win-win situation for everybody. So, back when I was in insurance, we would get together every morning and go over, okay, who had a sale yesterday or a meeting yesterday? How did it go? What did you say? What did they say? Did you sell something? Did you try this? And so every day, consistently, that's the importance here, is consistency in terms of refreshing the information and making certain that I had the skills to be able to, the next time that I came into a situation, I was prepared for it. And there's a great synergy of being together with all of your other fellow salespeople who can throw in, well, here's what I do, and have you tried this? Or definitely modify that action. And I found that extremely helpful. Those two things, speaking with other people and reviewing, listening to what they had done in their meetings, sharing what I had done, learning from each other, and then also finding podcasts and books of sales skills improvement. Hugely helpful. So that's the skill issue. I recommend definitely those two things, consistently talking about it and seeking out information. On the other side, we have will. What does will mean? Will actually is the desire to do the action. So here, as a person in this position of sales on our team, first we need to determine, are they really a salesperson? Do they have any proven track record? In many cases, they may have been hired because they were pleasant in the interview, they passed a drug test, and their psychological test gave the right answers to determine that this may be a diamond in the rough, let's give them a chance, but they have no background experience. So sales may not even be the right place for them. If it really truly isn't, then the sooner you can determine that and help them to pursue whatever it is that they really should be doing, the better. However, young people really don't know what is out there. And I would still say, getting back to my other point about we're always selling, I don't think there's a better profession than selling. Helping to bring people to get involved in something that's good for them. And again, like I said about Zig, if you help enough people do that, you're going to be successful. So I would always give someone the benefit of the doubt to say that they just need to be perhaps refocused. And so getting back to will, it's very important to develop a relationship of trust. How well do you really know your people? How well do you really know what's going on with their family? What is it that they're working hard to achieve and get to? Are they a single mom? Are they dealing with a sick relative? Are they themselves not healthy? Finding out more about the rest of their life can be extremely important, simply because how one person does one thing is absolutely going to permeate the other things that they do in their life. If you're off kilter in one area, you're not going to be doing well in others. We are told to leave our outside work outside, and when we're at work, work. Well, that's great, and it's true. However, very difficult to do if we don't have the ability to work through other issues in our life. So developing trust with a person to be able to see what's going on with them and help them put it in perspective, perhaps guide them to get the help that they need for whatever they're dealing with, and encourage them with the exciting things that they have going on in their life that are preoccupying them and taking their mental focus away from what they're doing. Okay, so basically you want to know, are they really into it? And if not, what's holding them back? And inspire them. Find out what is it that drives them. For example, getting back to my insurance experience, my supervisor loved it when we would buy a Mercedes or a $1,200 suit, because I remember the smile. Thank you, Paul. Because now he knew that we had to work harder to be able to keep those things. And typically there are things that we want in the future. And by doing well in our position, we're going to be able to do several things. Make a lot of money now. We're going to be recognized and feel good about that. We are often gonna create more doors to go down in the future and improve our opportunity and our job title, our position. Doors will open when we perform well in our task in front of us right now. So a conversation like that on a regular basis, getting to know your people really well, finding out what ails them, what motivates them, and then help them to work on those areas so that ultimately when they are at work, they know that what they're doing is helping other people to get involved in your product, so that they can ultimately, the salesperson that is, achieve their goals and work through their problems. And it all comes down to also being present in the moment. The problems or issues that we're trying to tackle outside are still gonna be there at the end of the day. And the future, none of us are promised. Right now, here we are in our sales position, and so we need to do what's right in front of us, which is find the people to help and help them get involved. So there you go. That's my thought on how to deal with being in a sales slump. I thank you very much for letting me be part of your success, and I'll see you again.